please. Acts chapter 16, verse number 26. This is a very familiar subject, but the most important subject ever preached. It is preached a lot, but yet still confusing to the multitude of people in this world today that just don't seem to understand how you go to heaven. How you have to be saved, the importance of it. There is so many different things taught in so many different churches on how a person gets to heaven. Now the Bible has one way to heaven. And it's being taught here, Acts chapter 16 and verse number 26. It's the story of the Philippian jailer who had put in responsibility of guarding the Apostle Paul in prison. And his entourage, and they were all put in prison, and they were one night singing and praising the Lord in jail. Most people don't do that. So let's look at this real quick, like, then we'll go to prayer. All right, found in Acts chapter 16, verse 26. The Bible says, "And suddenly there was a great earthquake, so that the foundations of the prison were shaken. And immediately all the doors were opened and everyone's bands were loosed. And the keeper of the prison awakened out of his sleep and seeing the prison doors open, he drew out his sword and would have killed himself, supposing that the prisoners had been fled. But Paul cried with a loud voice, saying, do thyself no harm, for we are all here. Then he called for a light and sprang in, and came trembling and fell down before Paul and Silas, and brought them out and said, sirs, what must I do to be saved? And they said, believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and thou shalt be saved and thy house. Father, what a wonderful testimony that these men were while they were in jail. Such a testimony that the prisoner wanted what they had. I pray, Heavenly Father, that you'll help everyone understand that there is only one way to heaven, that comes through Jesus Christ and what he did for them on the cross at Calvary. I pray, Heavenly Father, you'll bless this message to the hearts of the people. In Jesus' name, I pray. Amen. Well, trusting everybody had a wonderful Thanksgiving. Today is still a day in which our country is clouded with so much turmoil in it, with this here COVID-19 and all these things. But we still got a God in heaven taking care of things. I'm so glad of that. The Philippian jailer asked the question. Now, he was put in responsibility to take care of all those that were jailed. All those Christians that had been put into jail, and they hadn't been put in chains, and they were in some kind of a handcuff or some kind of irons that would keep them in place, but they were in jail, in prison. And the jailer, the Philippian jailer, where he's known as, was there to take care and to make sure they didn't go nowhere. Well, of course, during the midnight hour, they were singing and praising God, and the Lord worked a miracle. He caused an earthquake. The doors opened up. All the things went off of the chains were released, and all the irons were released that were having them captive. And all of a sudden, they're free. But they didn't go nowhere. They didn't run. They just stayed right there. But that was abnormal. And even the Philippian jailer knew that. Because he ran in there and knew that they would be gone, took out his sword, was going to kill him, and then Paul spoke up to him. Do thyself no harm. We are all still here. You see, the earthquake sent to set them free. That's why it came. God sent the earthquake to set his people free. They were rejoicing, having a good time in church. While they were in prison, they were using that as a church, and they were having a good time singing and praising the Lord, not being bothered at all that they were in chains. Their mind was on God, their mind was on singing the praises of the Lord. They were having a good time in church. Earthquake comes and set them free. Well, what happens here is that the Philippian jailer asked a question. After he seen that they were all there, he came in trembling with a light in his hand and said, "Sirs, what must I do to be saved?" That's an important question. If I was asking you the same question, what must I do to be saved? Could you tell me? Could you tell anybody else? You see, Paul knew how to get to heaven. He knew the only way to heaven. He knew exactly what to say. He told the Philippian jailer exactly what he needed to do. Believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and thou shalt be saved. Now, might be. That could be. Said, "You shall be saved." What must I do to be saved? Most important question ever asked. Anybody? The world needs Jesus. There's only one question you can ask. What must I do to be saved? There's only one answer to that question. Believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and thou shalt be saved. The Philippian jailer sprang in suddenly after he seen what took place, knew that he was going to die, was afraid of that. Because, you see, he was responsible. If those prisoners get loose, it's his responsibility. And he would die. That was Roman law. What you was put in charge of, you stay in charge of. You lose him, and you lose your life on top of it. You see, this earthquake shook the foundations. By the way, I want to tell you something about God. God has shook the foundations of this world ever since the world began. He's always shook it. And he'll shake it, continue to shake it. We think we got problems today. You think we got problems in this election. You think that all this corruption and all this cheating that went on, or if it went on, you think that surprises God? No. He knows. He's ready. I mean, he knows what's happening in this world. He knows what kind of people's out there. People are vile. People are wicked by nature. And they all need to ask the same question that the Philippian jailer asked. You see, he's seen in these Christians something that we don't see in a lot of Christians, by the way. He's seen them sing. He's seen them in jail. What would you say if you're in jail? Whatever, content, whatever state you're in, be content. The Bible says, what you so even they're in jail. So he knows, just praise God. And today, I'm telling you what, we can't do one blessed thing about what happened on election night. There's not a thing we can do about that. That's all going to be either settled in the courts or our court or it's going to go forward. One of the two. All we can do is sing praises unto the Lord. Worship God. Keep our faith. Serve the Lord. And the Philippian jailer looked at that testimony of those Christians and said, "Wow, what must I do to be saved?" Opened all the doors, the chests, the cells were open, the chains were off. The Philippian jailer's life stood in the balance. He knew he was going to die because he feared they were all gone. So he took his sword out to kill himself. We're still here. You see, our job is to run to people, not from people. As Christians, our job is to run to people. Tell them all about the gospel. That's the Great Commission. Share the gospel with folks. Tell them about Jesus Christ before his eternity tonight. You see, the fear of the jailer was found in verse number 27. I want you to look at that, please. Just verse number 27. And the keeper of the prison awakened out of his sleep, and seeing the prison doors open, he drew out his sword and would have killed himself, supposing, here's the fear, that the prisoners had been fled. Well, where were they going to go? They were going to go to the same kind of people they'd been going to before they were put into prison. Just everybody that needed Jesus Christ. He was awakened from his sleep. He saw the prison doors were open. Suppose they all went. He sought to kill himself before the overseers did it to him. So he'd rather do it his way, I suppose, than the way that they would have done it to him. So he's going to take his own life. But surprisingly, the Christian, the Trust in the Lord, and thou shalt be saved. Believe in the Lord Jesus Christ, and thou shalt be saved. Here's Paul. Here's Paul, the preacher. What's on his mind? Only things on his mind are everywhere. Tell people about God. That was his commission. Tell people about the Lord. That was his commission. Share the gospel. That's what he was supposed to do. It hadn't changed because he's in jail. Everything was the same. He had a message. The message was to the question. What must I do to be saved? The greatest question ever asked. Here's the greatest answer ever given to the greatest question. Believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and thou shalt be saved. Paul cried aloud. He cried to him to harm not himself. Don't you dare kill yourself. Called for a light. Now you understand, it was dark in that day. God in his life so he can tell others. See, the purpose of you getting saved is to tell somebody else about Jesus Christ. You see, from that point on, you'll see in the Bible that everybody knew about the saving power of Jesus Christ. It didn't matter if Jesus did it or his disciples came down on it, or today if we do it. People begin to see what God can do. That was MacArthur said when he left the Philippines during World War II. I'll send thousands of missionaries back to you. He knew what they needed. People today, we know what people need. We know they need the gospel of Jesus Christ. This world is divided, and a house divided cannot stand, the Bible says. Ladies and gentlemen, America is divided between a liberal philosophy and a conservative philosophy. We are divided, and a divided house cannot stand. That's why a married woman, a man, and both should be saved, because a divided home. Everybody who reads this portion of Scripture, every tract that has ever been made, that's ever been printed, that uses Acts chapter 16 and verse number 31, I believe it is, believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, thou shalt be saved. And been put out into all the world, printed page after printed page, with one message on it, the only message. Whether or not you're a Baptist or a Catholic or a Lutheran. Doesn't matter if you're Pentecostal, Presbyterian, it don't matter. The question is this: are you saved by the blood of the crucified one? Have you believed on the Lord Jesus Christ? Are you saved? Have you been saved by the blood? That's the only way to heaven. You come and join my church, that won't get you to heaven. You come and believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and thou shalt be saved. That's the greatest answer to the most important question ever given out. What must I do? What must I do to be saved? Come to this church, you'll find out the only way to heaven. And it's God's way. Jesus said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. No other way. Believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, and thou shalt be saved. Romans 10, 13. Whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, thou shalt be saved. He that hath the Son hath life. He that hath not the Son of God